The Florida Board of Education has unanimously approved new standards for how Black history will be taught in the state in public schools, and the updates are, well, disturbing to say the least. So I'm gonna start off with the most disturbing element of this new curriculum. The new standards require instruction for middle school students to include, get a load of this, how slaves develop skills which in some instances could be applied for their personal benefit. A document listing the standards and posted in the Florida Department of Education website said, and we double checked that ourselves, and that's what it says.
Yeah, so that is unreal, man. And there's another part of this that's unreal. So, but I want to give you context first. Remember when the conservatives started this and DeSantis and the others did, where they said, oh, look, we just don't want critical race theory being taught in the schools. Now, there are parts of critical race theory that I totally agree with, and there are parts of it where I go, well, I'm not so sure about that. That some of those positions are debatable. Good news, that's why they're not taught in any schools across the country, high school or lower. They're taught in graduate level courses, because there's controversial material in there, and it takes thought to wade through those issues, okay? But now we're not at critical race theory anymore. Now we're just whitewashing history.
Yeah, look, I totally agree with you. And look, I took a step back and I was like, look, obviously they're not teaching graduate level critical race theory in grade school. There's no way that's happening. But let me understand their argument, because maybe they're trying to argue that there are like traces of that curriculum in public schools, right? And if they genuinely believe that, how do you answer for the fact that they're trying to now input this like revisionist history about how, you know, there were some positive elements of slavery if you really think about it. Like this gives the whole game away. You get what I'm saying?
Exactly right, Anna. So I want to read graphics 2 and 3 because I think they're even more devastating. So CNN explains, when high school students learn about events such as the 1920 Ocoee massacre, the new rules require that instruction include quote, acts of violence perpetrated against and by African Americans. Now already that's disastrous, okay? Why are you putting in those two things in the same sentence? Why are you conflating them? But wait till you see the context. The context is much worse. I thought when I read that, they were saying, okay, now look, there was the Tulsa massacre and all these massacres and the lynchings, etc. But don't forget, Black people sometimes commit crimes. That already is terrible. Why are you mentioning that? So do white people, so do Asians. Why are you randomly mentioning that within the context of civil rights? But no, it's way worse. So here's the explanation. Instruction includes acts of violence perpetrated against and by African Americans, but is not limited to the 1906 Atlanta race riot, 1919 Washington DC race riot, 1920 Ocoee massacre, and that happened in Florida, that's why they mentioned it earlier, 1921 Tulsa massacre, and the 1923 Rosewood massacre. So when you see that, and then I read the longer explanation of it too, just to be absolutely sure. They're saying that these acts of violence happened to African Americans and by African Americans in reference to things like the Tulsa massacre and Rosewood and these massacres of African Americans, the one that happened in Florida.
Can I talk about that one?
Yeah.
Yeah, so that particular case had to do with a Black man by the name of Moses Norman. And he was a landowner in the community. This is in Florida, of course. And he decides, I'm gonna go vote. I'm gonna cast my ballot. He gets turned away by white poll workers. And then all of a sudden, he's eventually followed home by a mob of 250 people, white people, who killed dozens of African Americans. They set fire to their houses, just absolutely destroyed the community, drove the Black community out of their own community, just because this Black landowner wanted to cast a ballot and vote in the election.
So now, given that context, and by the way, 60 people were murdered, and they not only burned down their homes, but this is also interesting, they went out of their way to burn down their schools. Okay, and that was all for voting. Now in that context, they mention it as violence done to African Americans and by African Americans. Why are you playing the victim, blaming the victims in a scenario like this? Are you insane? How did that, it's almost like they're saying, well, you know, they had it coming. Now, this is disgusting, man. This isn't anywhere near critical race theory. This is just Republicans saying, we don't really like black folks, and we just we vomit it out wherever we are. So I mean, look, you tell me, Republicans, well, you love DeSantis. You gave him a 20-point win in Florida. What the hell is this crap?
Well, look, there's something really interesting happening, and by interesting I mean abhorrent, and it has to do with this revisionism I'm seeing on, look, obviously in this case with the right, but also with some on the fringes of the left. And it's to rewrite history and make it appear as though the gains that were accomplished and won during the civil rights movement were done so by the implementation of violence. And I think that that is inaccurate, to say the least. When we think about the leader of the civil rights movement, who do we think about? Martin Luther King Jr. Speech after speech, book after book, he makes his philosophy abundantly clear. And I want to give you just a short snippet of one of his speeches, but please watch the whole thing. Look it up online, it's readily available. Here's what his philosophy actually was.
We will never have peace in the world until men everywhere recognize that ends are not cut off from means, because the means represent the ideal in the making and the end in process. And ultimately, you can't reach good ends through evil means, because the means represent the seed and the end represents the tree.
So where's the violence by African Americans in this context? So here's Martin Luther King, the greatest civil rights leader, saying 1,000 times over, not only do we believe in nonviolence as an end, but as a means. We are always nonviolent, yet gratuitously the right wingers put it in there as if African Americans had these massacres coming. And then some on the left now maniacally have started to say, no, Martin Luther King was for violence. Why are you helping right wing framing when it's not anywhere near true, right? So no, please get an education, learn what Martin Luther King was about. And for the people in Florida now, that, well, when you go tell them to get an education, this is what their public schools are teaching them now. And this is really a war against teachers. This is a war against history. It's a war against truth. It's absolutely Orwellian, and it's made extra Orwellian by the people who claim that they're for freedom.
Look, we can go on, including, you know, talking about the individuals who are trying to pretend as though this isn't an attempt to whitewash history. It absolutely is. I just want to give you a few more details about this. So they lay out new benchmark clarifications to the existing black history curriculum that critics say ends up watering down the history. So the changes include teaching elementary school children to recognize Rosa Parks and Thomas Jefferson as individuals who represent the United States. The Florida Education Association criticized the approach, saying it excludes a deeper teaching of their histories and struggles in favor of easy identification and memorization. They also made sure to include how aggrieved the virtuous white people were in the 1800s. Instruction includes how whites who supported Reconstruction policies for freed blacks after the Civil War, white Southerners being called scalawags and white Northerners being called carpetbaggers, were targeted. So that's directly from the Florida State academic standards for 2023.
So look, I think the Rosa Parks criticism is legitimate. They should give you the context of why Rosa Parks was a hero, not just generically name her. But at least they mentioned her as an American hero. And I don't want anybody to get the wrong impression that they're not teaching slavery or civil rights at all. They are, they're just doing this reframing of it as slightly black people's fault. So to me, the Rosa Parks thing is a legitimate complaint, but doesn't necessarily show their hand. But when they say, oh, black people got all these benefits from being slaves, and by the way, the violence that was done against them was also kind of done by them, as Anna said, you're showing your hand.
Yep.
We now we know exactly what you actually think. Thanks for watching The Young Turks, really appreciate it. Another way to show support is through YouTube memberships. You'll get to interact with us more. There's live chat, emojis, badges. You've got emojis of me, Anna, John, JR. So those are super fun. But you also get playback of our exclusive member only shows and specials right after they air. So all of that, all you gotta do is click that join button right underneath the video. Thank you.